episode 2224, How to Deal with Stress.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive by. Happy, happy day. Did you wake up this morning knowing that you would carry a lot of stress? Well, it's time to throw all of that away. It's Wellness Wednesday. We're going to learn how to deal with stress. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, stress in everyday life can damage your health. Stop the grind in the body and mind. Learn how to deal with stress to live your best. You know, there are no easy answers to extinguishing stress. We have it. We got to learn how to deal with it, how to manage it. We have to go beyond just going, oh, I'm so tired of feeling this way. That keeps us in the excuse box. You've got to stop investing in your excuses. Yeah, I'm telling you like it is. It's important first, though. As we look at stress, where does it really show up in our life? Have you stopped long enough to say, how does stress affect my life? Well, it shows up in your love life. I mean, come on, let's be real. Your heart health, your teeth and gums even. Think about it. You're sleeping. Maybe you're even just kind of dozing off here and there and you're grinding your teeth. You know, your gums, that's not healthy. Your sleep, it's a disruptor to your sleep. Your emotions, talk about a roller coaster. Body weight, your immune system, aging, relationships, your job and career, your appetite. The crazy thing is that stress leaks into the nooks and crannies of our everyday. Plus, if we take it one step further, look at our thoughts. We have over 12,000 to 50,000 thoughts on average a day, which is primarily negative or neutral. And when you look at it that way, this becomes the greatest recipe for stress. You're like, yeah, give me that recipe. Sign me up. You're like, oh, no, I don't want it. I have enough. Then you got to understand that because of all of this stress that's going on in your life, the more it happens, what is it called? You got it, chronic stress, the kind that persists when you can't resist. This can lead to elevated blood sugar, which can increase the risk to diabetes, weakened immune system, leaky gut, reduced ability to burn fat and increased belly fat, increased risk of depression and anxiety, plus mood imbalances. I mean, really? You want to sign up for all of that stuff? But yet we do it every single day. We allow stress to consume us. We eat when we're stressed. We sleep poorly when we're stressed. But the thing is that we haven't yet realized is we can't eliminate all of our stress. That's impossible. And this is you being realistic. I mean, come on, I'm being real with you here. Stress is a part of our everyday, period, end of story. Maybe we should even put an exclamation point on it. But that doesn't mean that we can't do something about it. So increase your chances to reduce your stress by being your best with breaths. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Be your best with breaths. Now try to say that 10 times over. Seriously. When I was writing this down, I was like, hey, this is kind of catchy. Be your best with breaths. But then I said it out loud and I'm like, well, if I don't say it right, it's going to sound wrong. So hopefully that has put a smile on your face because I really want you to remember this. Stress is not something to laugh about, but it is something we can deal with, okay? There are simple things we can do. Are they easy? No, there aren't. But here is where you breathe your way to stress relief. What does it look like? I'm going to give you three ways when it comes to your breathing patterns, two of which I have been doing for a very long time, like decades. One I have recently introduced myself to, and I love it also. There is a time and place, so I want to walk you through it because I think you can take one of these three and apply it in your everyday. Start slow, figure out what works, and then when you begin to really hone in and focus – and you're just targeted and zoned in this one area, like, oh my gosh, when my daughter says this, or when my son comes at me like this, or when my husband or my boss, right? You fill in the blank, whoever it is, whatever it is, the situation, you get triggered. You can allow yourself to say, you know what? I can calm myself right here. I don't have to let myself go that direction. But understand, it takes work. So number one, elongated inhale and exhale. This is where you focus on your breaths in and out. Some would say this is the beginner of breathing. But the difference here is that you are focused on it. Plus, if your mind then begins to drift, you got to redirect your focus on the sound and feeling of your breathing patterns. Let me give you an example. My grandson, oh my gosh, is he not precious? Oh, he's adorable. Yes, I know he is because he's mine. Well, he is now 4 months old. And oh my gosh, he is just a little spitfire. And what's interesting though, and I've done this for a very long time. I watch people's breathing patterns. I listen to them. I can see things happening before they know they're happening now. Maybe some people would call me weird. It's just that I'm very observant. I watch, I listen. And so with my grandson, he's so little that when he was just brought home from the hospital with my daughter and son-in-law, oh my gosh, I would watch him and I could tell he was about ready to just scream. And I was like, oh, here it comes. And sure enough, boom, opens his mouth and he's crying. Now, I went down there last weekend and enjoyed some time with him and my daughter. And so it was funny because I would watch him. He's older now. And I would watch his patterns. And I'm like, just watch. And you know what was amazing to me is how intricate we are. Like, we don't give God enough credit. I mean, I'm serious here. We don't. Our bodies are incredible. You should be thanking your lucky stars and God, of course, that God has given you the body he's given you, even if you don't like it, because I know I have that conversation quite often with him. You know, I want to be taller, doesn't work. You know, it's like, well, Christine, you're tall as you're going to get, so deal with it. I'm like, seriously, Lord, you know, we could have this conversation. But one thing that fascinates me every single time that I really hone in on the breathing part of life, you know, yesterday's episode was every breath is a blessing. Hence, be your best with breaths. That's the key here. Focus in on what am I feeling at this moment in time. Well, when my little grandson is about ready to explode, man, I can see his breathing patterns shift and they get a little bit faster. And then sometimes I'll slow down and then they ramp back up. And then all of a sudden it's like, okay, I'm frustrated here. And now I'm going to use my vocals because I know I love the sound of me and I'm going to let it all out and I'm going to sing at the top of my lungs. He's not singing, he's screaming. But it gets our attention, right? Well, it's cute kind of as a baby. But when you get our age, do we really need to be screaming all the time? Now I know, turn on some of the channels and that seems to be all you get now. Our people aren't even communicating. They're just yelling back and forth. Stop it already. Let's begin to calm and reduce our stress levels. Use elongated inhale and exhale. Breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. Now, I kind of whistled there for you because I wanted you to hear the breath. It was slow and steady. Now, that takes practice. It doesn't come easy. And if you breathe too close together because you're actually telling your body to breathe, it's not on automated pilot here, right? You are saying, I'm going to inhale now and I'm going to control it and I'm going to exhale. Now, you can count in. Some people like to count in 4, exhale 5, whatever. I'm not going to go into that. I want you just to breathe elongated, longer than what you normally do. And for some, that may be, I'm done. But eventually it'll be, I'm done. Do you feel that? There's a different sense. So use elongating inhale and exhale. Also, this one here specifically is great if your spouse or your children or even a stranger, anybody is all of a sudden kind of just triggering you and you can feel your blood pressure going. And you're like, seriously here? Use some elongated inhale and exhale. You don't have to make it real big. You know, here I'm trying to make noises because you're not seeing me visually in my breathing patterns. You have to hear me. And so it's important to know that when I'm breathing, you can tell, right? When I get excited, I talk faster and my breaths, you know, they get shorter and shorter because I'm talking faster and faster. And sometimes I talk so much and I put so many words together that I don't even take a breath and I just keep going and going and going. Energizer bunny injection here. No. Now, yeah, we can feel that. We hear it. It's a sensation. But we also have to learn how to slow our bodies down. That's control. And that's really what you're aiming for here. So if your kiddos are beginning to, you know, kind of push your buttons a little bit, work on your elongated inhale and exhale. You don't have to sit there and make the noises. I'm doing it so you can hear it. You understand it. And pretty soon what will happen is it literally can be a switch that you flip, that when you're in a situation, you begin to go into this breathing pattern and it helps to slow things down, which allows you to what? To respond versus to react. And that's the key here. You don't want to react all the time. Reactions do not come with thinking. It just comes with emotion and feeling. You want to have a response so you can control that. And then you can say, okay, let's logically think this through. How do I really need to handle myself? And wouldn't you agree we need a little bit more on the response side of life versus the reaction side of life? So elongate your inhale and exhale. Number two, diaphragmatic breathing. Love this one. This is also known as abdominal breathing, okay? It helps you to reduce the fight flight response. Now, in the olden days, way back when, this was awesome, meaning the fight flight. We need stress then. Why? Because it makes us more alert. It makes us want to, you know, run if we need to. All of a sudden, our senses are heightened. And so diaphragmatic breathing can actually allow us to control that fight or flight. Now, understand this. I've been doing diaphragmatic breathing for decades. As a musician, as a flautist, I've had to learn to breathe properly, and that is diaphragmatic breathing. A lot of us, and I want you to think about how you breathe. Are you breathing only through your chest, or does your stomach rise and fall? Seriously, what does it do? Now, you're probably like, well, I haven't thought about that. Right, we don't think about it. We just breathe. No one's told me, well, let's study my breathing patterns. Well, today I kind of am, because you got to learn how to deal with stress. And you can be your best with breaths. And in doing that, you got to lock into diaphragmatic breathing. Now, this is not something that comes easy. It is simple, but you got to practice it. One way to do it is you can lay down on the floor. I love doing it this way. It's a great starting position. Plus, it's very relaxing. Put your feet, position them however you're comfortable. Place your hands on your stomach just slightly above your belly button. So think about between your rib cage, the bottom of your rib cage, and your belly button, your natural belly button, okay? And then put your fingers somewhat not overlapping where you're interlocking them, but where they just cross each other. So every other one. So your left hand would be your pointer finger, then your right hand would be your pointer finger. Then your left hand would be your middle finger. You get the idea, right? But you're not locking them. Because what you're going to do is when you breathe in, your stomach is going to rise. Okay, so if you're laying down on the floor, you're going to think of your stomach rising. That means your hand separates slightly. It's not going to come all the way apart. That's a little extravagant. It's going to separate just a little bit. Then when you exhale, then they're going to do what? Come together. Inhale, they come apart. Exhale, they come together. And what you want to be able to do is to control this. Now, you can do that lying down. You can also do it sitting up. And you can place your hands, not interlocking, but just kind of hanging over. Again, the side thing, right? Your pointer finger next to your left pointer finger, next to your, you know, right middle finger, next to your left middle finger. You get the idea. Put it on the back of you, okay? So where your spine is, just slightly overlapping them, but they're not clasped. And you're going to breathe. And when you breathe in your abdominal area, your diaphragmatic breathing, your actual diaphragm is raising up. So that means you are inflating your stomach. So it's going to rise. And that means your back is also going to expand. It's going to come out. And then when you exhale, it's going to come in. This is called diaphragmatic breathing. It is awesome. It takes practice, but it is incredible. And believe it or not, yes, I have been doing this for decades because I've been playing my flute for decades. So that does help me, and it does a great thing. So when you think about it, I've been training to handle stress for a long time, my entire life practically, which is kind of cool to think about it. Here I thought I was just learning a technique for my flute when really I was also saving my life because I'm reducing my stress. So breathing does a lot for us. We take it for granted. Don't. Every breath is a blessing. Number one, elongated inhale, exhale. Number two, diaphragmatic breathing. Number three, nostril breathing. This is brand new to me. I have been doing it recently over the last almost 2 years or so. I do enjoy it. And this is where you breathe through one of your nostrils while exhaling through the opposite nostril. And then you reverse the process. So let's say you're going to breathe through, and I know this is going to be hard, but I'm going to try to demonstrate it so you can hear it. And I'm going to do it at the same time so it makes sense to you. So I'm going to breathe through. I'm going to press my finger slightly on the left side of my nose. So I'm going to close one side. You can tell the difference in my voice. I'm going to breathe in through the right nostril. I'm going to hold it for a moment, and then I'm going to push with my right hand on my right side of the nostril and exhale. Now understand here, that was a short exhale. It should be longer, but I was talking also. So I was exhaling to you as I was talking. So yes, I was cheating. You can't talk and do nostril breathing properly. Okay. It really is a calming thing. I love to do this after a good workout during my cool down. This just allows me to really begin to center my mind, think about the muscles that I utilized through my workout, whether it's walking, whether it's running, whether it's during my strength training. This allows me just to say, okay, I got this. So it's nostril breathing. Practice it. So then if you do right to left, then you do left to right. Makes sense? So you just reverse the process. And you do that, I would gauge that you do it 4 to 5 times the first time. You got to be careful and cautious of this. When you breathe, depending upon how you normally breathe, you can get a little lightheaded if you're breathing either too long or too slow. So I would recommend, as you're starting to practice these techniques, do it in a safe environment. Two reasons. One, pandemic. Two, because I don't want you passing out. Seriously. So sit down. Be on the floor. Be on your bed. Be on a chair. It's all about safety first, right? Okay. So this is important. Stress is always going to be around, but you can manage your stress. But remember, it's going to take dedicated effort from you. So don't give up on life just because you're just feeling like totally overwhelmed. We use that word too when it comes to stress. We're overwhelmed. We just don't know what to do. Yeah, you're stressed out. You don't need your cortisol firing unnecessarily. Because guess what? If you want to lose weight, cortisol is not something you want happening. You want to level everything out. You want to level the playing field. You want to control what is firing in your body. If you're constantly living in a fight or flight or freeze lifestyle, then what does that do for your body? Yeah, it's consistently in what? Battle. You're constantly at war. Why do you think you're exhausted all the time? Why do you think that you just can't get the sleep that you want? You're tossing and turning. You can't think clearly. You've got a foggy mind. You're short-tempered. You get angered easily. All these are signs that you're kind of stressed a little bit and maybe pushing it. And stress leads to other things. So learn to manage it. And these are three simple ways that breathing can reduce your stress. Go out today, train for life, love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.